Permafrost shapes the landscape as far as you can see, either by its presence or absence. Permafrost is any earth material, like dirt or rocks, that doesn't thaw in the summer due to a very cold climate. Some permafrost is tens of thousands of years old. Permafrost is not necessarily ice.
Permafrost could be very ice rich, and then you will find very significant amount of ice in it in different form. It could be just small crystals inside of soil, or it could be some lenses of pure ice, or it could be thick lenses of pure ice, or it could be big masses of ice, like ice wedges, for example. So the variety of amount of ice in permafrost could be very different, from none, from zero, to 95% by volume.
Permafrost is found both in the northern and southern hemispheres and around the globe. Where it is found is a function of climate, latitude, and elevation.
In the southern latitudes, there is not too much land, and most of this land covered with Antarctic ice sheet. So there is not too much permafrost exposed to the surface. However, in the northern hemisphere, there's plenty of land mass. Permafrost actually area occupies about 1/4 of the land mass of the northern hemisphere.
Permafrost plays an important role in the landscape traversed by the Dalton Highway. In the subarctic zone south of the Brooks Range, permafrost is discontinuous. It only occurs in locations where the conditions are exactly right. North of the Brooks Range, the permafrost is continuous.
That means that it's practically everywhere, except for very special places like under big, deep lakes or big rivers, which there is not too many of them, along the Dalton Highway. So on the North Slope, it's very safe to say it's everywhere.
But it is not always easy to see. There are clues if you know where to look and what to look for. Driving through the boreal forest, black spruce are the main clue to detect permafrost. Many people wonder what's wrong with the trees. Because the dark spindly trees grow on permafrost, they grow slowly and rarely are robust because their roots cannot grow deep. In the north, flat marshy tundra areas are another clue. Because water cannot percolate through frozen ground, it remains on the surface in areas that are too flat for runoff. By far the easiest way to find permafrost is to look for changes in the landscape.
The easiest to find where is permafrost is looking at the road. If road is nice and smooth, maybe there is no permafrost. When it's bumpy, that's definitely permafrost there. And changes in permafrost, that's what we can see. If permafrost doesn't change, it's very difficult to see it from the surface. But when it starts to change because of warming in climate, changes in some surface conditions, human activities, road construction, permafrost can start to thaw, and then we see consequences of this very easily.